We are now moving on to the third and final session of the day on track biomedical engineering. A speaker for this session is Dr. Shubha DP. She is an associate professor, Department of Electrical Engineering, NIT Calicut, and she has completed several research projects with grants like nonlinear analysis of EEG signals of patients with Alzheimer's disease and nonlinear analysis of signals in biomedical application, etc. It is indeed a pleasure to have you here, ma'am. Over to you.
Thank you very much. Hope my screen is visible and hope I'm audible too.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. So, good evening, one and all. I am Shubhadi Puthangattil, working in the Department of Electrical Engineering at NIT Calicut. So let me on the onset thank the organizers of IEEE Malabar subsection for giving me this opportunity to introduce the discipline of biomedical engineering to the engineering aspirants. Okay, so what I would be covering will be what is biomedical engineering, why is it significant, its usefulness, who all are eligible for this, and courses offered at UG and PG, and curriculum in short, and also the job prospects of biomedical engineering discipline. Okay, so to know further, biomedical engineering is nothing but the integration of engineering principles with the principles of medical sciences. So it is nothing so, it's not a jargon, it's very simple thing that we are applying whatever principles of engineering we learn to the principles of medical sciences. So in short, I can just show you as this. It is the application of engineering principles and methods to solve both medical and biological problems. So you would have heard of different disciplines in engineering like electrical, mechanical, chemical, life sciences, etc. So what you do is you try to integrate the principles associated with the engineering, such as that of electrical, mechanical, chemical, all that to solve the different problems which are there in medical field. So it will finally end up in the development of new healthcare technologies and systems. So make it clear, development of new healthcare technologies, suppose, because we all know that suppose when you have some problem, we go to a doctor. When we go to a doctor, sometimes the doctor suspects something and then they'll ask us to take a scan, or sometimes for further diagnosis, he will to confirm a diagnosis, he will ask us to take a scan, or he will ask us to take an X-ray. So all these devices are actually developed in view of making or streamlining the healthcare services in the country. So this biomedical engineering is actually formulated with a view of providing better healthcare services for the people in our country. And then, so it involves the study, the design, the development, and evaluation of the systems and products. It includes the artificial organs. Suppose, because you would have heard about artificial valves, you would have heard about artificial implants, prosthetics. No, you would have heard about prosthetics because you would have heard about Paralympics, isn't it? Immediately after the Tokyo Olympics, what is coming up is the Paralympics, isn't it? So where you would have read about or seen that people without limbs, people who have missed certain body parts would be taking part in this Olympics. So that is prosthetics, which would help them to take part in the Olympics. Then medical instruments. So you would have come across different types of medical instruments when you go to a hospital, X-ray machines, EEG machines, ECG machines, then all these sorts of microscopes and other things, which would help you in diagnosing a disease, and certain information systems. So the aim or the prospects of a biomedical engineer is to study, design, develop, and evaluate these systems and products which would help us or help the doctors or the engineers to come up with assisting the people with many either disorders or with many shortcomings. Then the usefulness of biomedical engineering. So this is basically a multidisciplinary area of study, and the aim is finally to assist the doctors and physicians in their healthcare practices, either to speed up the diagnosis with a computer-aided design or to help them predict the disease rather than going for hours of looking through the ECGs or the signal waveforms or the analog waveforms. Analog means the recorded waveforms in paper, in print format. So without that, with the help of the advancements in the field of biomedical engineering, we could assist. So a biomedical engineer could assist the doctors and physicians in helping them to speed up the diagnosis and also help them to predict the diseases, unlike the existing methods where they have to have multiple sittings to make a prognosis. Okay. And this study also helps them in the rehabilitation of disabled patients. Just as the previous talk, what Dr. Srikanth has mentioned, like robotics would always help them in assisting them with a robotic arm, which would help them. For example, if you would have heard of cerebral palsy people, so with the help of robotic arm, it would help them to lead a life which could help them to do their daily routine without much of a manual intervention. Okay, so this robotic arms would help them. So all these are a part of rehabilitation of disabled patients. So this is all devised by biomedical engineers. Now, who all are eligible for this engineering discipline? So those who have completed their plus two in science stream from a recognized board, either CBSE, AAC, or the state boards, who have taken either physics, chemistry, who have taken physics, chemistry, and maths, could write the qualifying exam, which is JEE. So you would have these courses being offered by many private and reputed institutes funded by centrally funded agencies or by the ministries. So by writing the JEE means you are eligible to apply for these courses. And also there are many private institutions both in Kerala and outside Kerala who offer this biomedical engineering as a UG level course. Then it is basically offered as an at undergraduate level. It is a 4-year BTech program, or it is also a 5-year integrated BTech MTech program. So the one which is more commonly available is a 4-year BTech program, but there are certain universities which usually offer it as a 5-year integrated BTech along with the MTech program. And the curriculum, you don't have to worry much about the curriculum, which would include basically engineering, mathematics, chemistry, physics, some fundamentals on electrical engineering, electronic engineering, civil engineering, mechanical engineering, and programming languages, then introduction to human anatomy and physiology, which our MBBS students study in the first year, and also courses on electrical and electronic instruments, signals and systems, then medical informatics, expert systems, medical instrumentation, biomedical signal processing, biomaterials, advanced biomedical instruments, hospital safety and management, engineering economics, biotelemetry, etc. Please don't worry about all these names of these subjects. Once you are into the stream, it becomes all easy for you to proceed with all these subjects. And the job prospects of this course are, you can either turn up to a biomedical engineer who can assist the doctors with the use of all the instruments which are associated with recording or taking a signal from the human body, or an instrument engineer who can do the maintenance, or who can help the doctors with information on how to use the instrument, or be along with the doctor during the recording of a signal from a human body. Then installation engineer, who would specifically be working on the installation, maintenance, and repair of these biomedical engineers, or as a researcher in R&D labs, or as a maintenance engineer who would be exclusively dealing with the maintenance of the biomedical equipments. Then at undergraduate, so we have seen the undergraduate level course. Now when it is a graduate, suppose those who are planning to pursue a graduate level course or higher studies can go for a two-year MTech program, where their eligibility is to complete their graduation either in biomedical engineering or biotechnology branch from a recognized university or institute. Or those candidates who possess an MBBS degree can also pursue a postgraduate course in biomedical engineering. Now, there are certain institutes who have tie up with nationally reputed institutes such as IITs, along with hospitals like Sri Jitra and other hospitals like CMC Vellore, and they have a combined program which offers MTech program in clinical engineering, for which their eligibility is a graduation in biomedical engineering or biotechnology. So the specializations further in biomedical engineering are surgical instruments and medical devices engineering, biomaterials engineering, biosignal processing engineering, biomechanics engineering, computational modeling, tissue engineering, neural engineering, telehealth communication engineering, and medical image processing. So there are certain biomedical companies hiring biomedical engineers. So some of them, I have listed some of them: Siemens Healthcare, Johnson & Johnson, GE Healthcare, Dräger, Fresenius Medical Care, Macquet, Stryker, Philips Healthcare, Samsung Healthcare, Braun. And there are a multitude of companies who hire biomedical engineers, either as engineers for their technical wing or as researchers for their R&D labs. So apart from all these, you have also biomedical engineers being hired by aerospace companies as well as NASA for their R&D labs. So those who are looking forward to have some acquaintance or some job prospects in NASA can surely take biomedical as their engineering discipline, so that you can, if you have a dream, you can surely end up as a researcher in their R&D labs. So thank you. With this, I would like to wind up. So good luck for all the engineering aspirants. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you for enlightening the gathering about biomedical engineering.